out of there, Mr. Brockway. How are you doing?
All right, how are you?
Hello.
This is fun. We like you.
You should have come last night.
Thank you.
was one of 13 girls. Girls who came to the castle looking to wed the prince, but who, for one reason or another, were found to be unsuitable. As a matter of fact, the day I arrived in court, they were testing princess number 12. A curious quiz was in progress.
Are you ready for the next question?
I guess so.
The next question concerns famous rulers. Are you quite ready?
Uh-huh.
Well then, name me three kings. Is that clear?
Yes. Would you repeat the question, please?
Certainly. Name me three kings.
May I take your third king first?
Yes.
Well, then, the three kings are...
Is this a trial?
No, it's the royalty test to find out if she's a real princess.
King John, King Arthur...
But does it matter if she's a true princess?
Oh, yes. If she's a true princess, we can all get married.
And King Ethelred...
She's the best one yet. Can I marry now, Dad, please?
Oh, no, sweetheart. There's still one more question.
This test isn't going to be fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
Law?
The marriage law? Throughout the land, no one may wed till Dauntless to the altar's led.
Dauntless?
The prince! Until he gets married, none of us can.
You are now leaving the seventh plateau, but here is your final question. It is divided into four parts and concerns a man often referred to as the Knight of the Red Cross. One, what was his name? Two, what beast did he slay? Three, how many rows of teeth did he have? And four, what was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blessed boy who stole the kill of the beast?
Don't dilly-dally, Dauntless, it's nearly time for your cocoa.
yes, I am sober.
Brendan, Brendan, come here, man. Now, watch closely as I take a quick plane in this apartment. No deserve, no cut corners or concealed pockets. Well, what is it?
Excuse me, Carmen, but I have to take the Mitchell to sign up with the gas steward.
No, Mr. Kovacs.
This way, please.
I'm on my way to Norman. I won't be staying long.
For your father's sake, I put up with a good deal of chicanery from you. Just because your father and I were in show business, don't listen.
Oh, Sir Harris!
My darling! You missed the text!
Sweet Larkin! My due responsibilities as chivalric knight of the Herald keep me busy.
The latest princess was a failure.
No!
Yes!
Bad luck. But don't despair, for we have plenty of time. If a true princess is not found in the next few months, I will go out and find one myself, or I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling?
My love?
Do you remember the royal joust on Whitsunday when you won those spurs?
Of course.
When you were called Sir Harry, the fairest and greatest knight in all the land, and everyone agreed you had a brilliant future ahead of you, that you might someday become Lord Chamberlain, or even Prime Minister?
Well, I don't know about Prime Minister.
Do you remember the picnic we all had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down?
Yes.
And the lark was singing in the trees, and you said that you'd remember that moment forever because the lark's song reminded you of my name?
Yes. Lark Jack, yes.
And then we watched the sun go down?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby. Oh, Harry. This could ruin you if you've never been Prime Minister or anything. Say the word, Harry, and I'll go now. I'll go far away, but they'll never find me. Just say the word.
No. No, you'll stay here. Why should we both suffer all our lives just because you had a moment of weakness?
Oh, Harry.
We're none of us perfect. Everything's going to be all right. Thank you.
me.
Oh, of course, Mama.
Well, how can you say such a thing? I want you to get married. How many times have I said to you, I want you to get married? Just the other day, I was telling your father I said, Sextimus, I want that boy to get married. It just isn't normal for a boy that age to stay single. And after all, he is the prince. I said, don't forget that. He's next in line to the throne. I mean, we're not exactly the oldest people in the world, but then again, we're not going to live forever. And I just know that I would be more relaxed in my mind finding that you were married and settled and set. And that is absolutely verbatim, exactly what I said to your father. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But you know him just as well as I do. I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. But that's just my cross of pain. And if he makes me miserable and makes me suffer, I just have to put up with it. And I don't want that to affect my child's attitude toward him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, selfish, rotten man, but he is your father, and I want you to respect him. There is only one person who really cares about you and your health and your happiness and your future, and that's what I'm talking about. Right now, your future. And I want to make myself perfectly clear. I want you to get married, but I don't want you to marry just anybody. After all, marriage is a lifetime partnership that I wouldn't want to see my little boy make the same mistake I did or the miserable the way I did. And you must marry someone suitable. Someone good enough, nice enough, sweet enough, and smart enough. Remind my nice, sweet, beautiful little baby boy. And she has to be a princess. I mean a real princess. That is something I absolutely insist upon. She has to be a real, genuine, bona fide princess, just as I was. That's what you want, isn't it? Someone like me? Of course you do! Oh God, if I wasn't 20 years younger. Just remember this, you must trust me.
Your Majesty, your Highness.
Hello, Harry.
Shut up! Well.
Sir Harry wishes to speak to you, madam.
Well.
Madam, I have the honor to request a perilous labor. I plan to search for a true princess, a princess of royal blood, one who will suit both your Majesty and Prince Douglas.
No.
Mama!
No, no, no. We've already been through all the eligible girls in all the neighboring kingdoms. There are none left. We simply have to wait for their little sisters to grow up, and that took years.
But madam, I play you in north, over the mountains.
Over the mountains.
Across the badlands.
Across the badlands.
And into the marshlands where the beautiful swamp lily grows.
Into the marshlands. Are you out of your mind?
Mama, let me go!
You won't find anything there. Frogs and tadpoles and things.
Mama!
Do you know what the weather there is like?
Please!
How damp and foggy.
Mama!
Quiet! And humid and oppressive.
Mama! Sir Harry, try, please, for me!
All right, go ahead. It's your son.
Yeah! Yeah!
Come along now, Douglas. Now, it's your turn.
Good luck, Harry!
Don't be afraid, little Larkin. I'll bring you a princess who is not only a real princess, but one who will be able to pass the queen's test.
I believe you. I'm not afraid.
And I shan't be away long.
Only fly as fast as you can, my love. We shall be waiting for you.
We?
You know. And wear this.
Next to my heart.
Sunday morning at mid-April, when the crocuses were just beginning to dot the meadows. The lookout from the north ground tower spied two distant figures approaching at full gallop. The alarm was spread. Sir Harry is back! Sir Harry is back with the new princess! Now, let's see. How does that part go in the old story?
On a stormy night to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for.
That, of course, is simply untrue. It wasn't storming that night at all. In fact, it wasn't even night, and the princess only looked as though she'd come in from the store.
We tried to stop her, but she something.
No! Do you imagine for one moment I could consider you suitable for any son of mine? You are laboring under a very unfortunate misdirection, my dear. My son isn't going to marry any monk swimmer, not while I still have breath in my body. And I haven't been feeling well. Not well at all. I have these shooting pains all through in here. Don't try to tell me it's the vapors. I know what the vapors are. Dad, the vapors.
Excuse me, madam, are you new here? Well, splendid, splendid. Watch closely as I can get typically paid in these apartments. Notice it has no cut corners or concealed pockets. And then...
not
steps, but then I landed this gesture job, and what's wrong?
that is worse, I am another one of those princesses to go with. And I am in no mood to sit for hours in a stuffy chamber, racking my brain for a girl when I'm not feeling all that well. But that's the way Dauntless wants it. That's the way it'll be. She'll have the test.
Well, the flavors do seem to be in order.
Oh no, and the worst of it is that foolish boy actually seems so like the girl.
Yes.
So we must think of a test that looks fair, sounds fair, seems fair, and isn't fair. When you got the idea, test for the senses of an actor of applauding my own mouth. But exactly what?
Oh, table manners.
Not good enough.
First.
I
captivating face, I realize how poor my description must have been.
Sir Harry's not very good at describing people.
Well, he may not know how to describe her, but he sure knows how to pick up. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to return these to the fourth floor.
I've never been so humiliated in my life!
What's the matter?
I thought you were the chambermaid!
What?
A chambermaid!
What in hell could you? How could you mistake the princess for a chambermaid?
How could I? How could you mistake that chambermaid for a princess?
Don't say such a thing! Just because you made a stupid mistake.
I made a mistake? Don't you dare try to blame it on me!
I do blame it on you.
She was on her hands and knees scrubbing the floor!
She's a real lady wherever she was. That's more than I can say for some people around here.
I hate you!
Well, I hate you too!
Yeah!
Don't worry, I know.
Enjoy any of it with my back and that strange nagging pain in my jaw.
Oh God, no one will ever know what I suffer.
What was she jabbering about? Yeah, same as usual.
What is it?
I don't know.
Come fly with me, come drive the train, come. in turn.
Uh-huh.
For instance, one of the girls is supposed to lift this weight. She couldn't do it.
Oh, part of the mattress. Oh! It's a dead body. Pull it. Well, what are you doing? Explain yourself.
It was just a doctor, Majesty. This boy, yeah, boy, man. We just go out and play, Lancelot.
Lancelot? Wait!
Lady Larkin.
What are you doing? Explain yourself.
Your Majesty,
shut up! What are you doing in that ridiculous skin?
Your Majesty,
silence! And why were you at the ball?
Your Majesty,
be quiet! And what are you doing with this man? Answer me!
I was just...
Well, speak up!
Your Majesty,
you were running away, weren't you?
Larkin.
You were running away! Why, you low-born, ungrateful little sneak! Is this the thanks I get for treating you as my own daughter? Imagine one of my girls running off with a musician!
Your Majesty, I tell the truth. Lady Larkin is innocent. I forced her to leave against her will.
That's not true!
Just a moment!
Larkin, what are you doing with this man?
Well, what are you doing with that woman?
Just a moment!
You go to your room!
Then you tell me what to do! Leave it to me!
Quiet! Might I remind you that you are still one of my ladies in waiting? Get up upstairs where you belong to prepare what's her name.
Your Majesty, I was...
Do as I say. And might I remind you that you are still one of my knights? Sir Harry Stepford. And you, relax. Sir Harry, I ordered this minstrel banished from my kingdom. I want him out of here by daybreak. Sextus, go to bed. I don't want you groping around in the dark. And the rest of you, listen closely. There was a little girl upstairs who is dog tired.
Oh no, she said you were going to study for her test.
All right, let her study. But when she's done, I want her to get a good rest, so I want it quiet around here. I mean, I want quiet, and I'm going to get quiet if I have to scream the palace down. Fight!
The queen has ordered me to remind what the queen has ordered. Just sit down. But your highness, now,
on me.
Oh, your highness.
Now, you just go be the something pretty that shows you're a girl and can't think of everything.
Oh, Markin, try not to be a little helpless. Men don't like girls that are too strong.
Bye, you!
Dear princess, I don't know how to thank you. If it's a girl, I'm going to name her Fred.
But what if it's a boy?
Dauntless, you better go to bed now. I'll leave the picture book.
Well, I'm sure you'll pass Mama's test tomorrow. Well, at least I think it will. If you don't, I'll understand.
Sir Harry, I can't leave yet. The
someone I must see first.
Who?
The wizard. I want your permission to speak to the wizard.
Yes! Yes!
No, permission denied.
Sir Harry, you're a fathead!
Yes, you are. He's trying to help. We're all trying to help.
How can you help?
By finding out what the test is from the wizard.
That's cheating.
Don't you understand? This is for you.
Let me see the wizard.
No. If anyone should defy the wizard's chicanery, I should.
You must stand guard.
This is my job.
No, Your Majesty, you might get hurt.
You can't come in that fight.
What's the matter, Papa?
The king mustn't come with us.
How dare you? Your Majesty, now Prince Dauntless is ready now. He needs to have that little personal talk with you.
Well, some other time.
Dauntless, your father needs to have that little chat with you now. It's very important.
Yes?
It can't be put off. Come on. Do your duty, sire.
What is it, Papa? What do you want to talk about?
Well, Papa?
Boy. Listen. Boy. Flower. Girl. Flower. Boy, flower, girl, flower. I'll tell you more. I want to know about what getting married for. Fall, go flowering, and by and by, baby flower, you grow home. I'll tell you why, I'll tell you why. Oh, father, tell me, father, don't be shy. Boy flower, girl flower, love each other. Boy flower, father, girl flower, father, yet to the how. Very interesting, but how you tell me now? B, my boy flower, boy flower's dust gets on me. He flies to your flower, dust touches your flower. Oh, I see. No, I don't see. It's very interesting, but still I couldn't be. What is like your flower? Name is like B. And like, boy flower, man, that's me. Well, tell me more, I want to know about what getting married is for. Sounds like Carrie. Sounds like Mary. Mary! Man and woman get married. Wife, love each other. And then one night, yes, yes, one night, and Mary. What happens in the night? What happens? What happens? Don't bother, tell me, please. Shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees? Princess Winifred and I will get married. And then, one night,
wait a minute, Papa!
chicanery, if you please.
This is not chicanery. And I wouldn't even bother to say it, except for the fact that I've been banished. And before I go, well, I just had to tell you what a great artist you are. Cardamon.
Cardamon, don't call me by that name.
I use that name with honor, sir. I don't think that I'll ever forget seeing you in Glastonbury in 92. What a show! What a triumph! You took 7 curtain calls!
8!
Oh, yes. Well, do you remember a boy in the second row who stood and yelled, Bravo, that night?
Yes, yes, I do.
I was that boy.
No, I can't believe it!
Yes, of course, I'm in show business now as well. And I just wanted to say to the wizard that it was your inspiration that brought this about.
Well, you must be part of the guild. Camelot Yellow, 714. To think that anybody remembers that stage.
Yes, well, I just wanted to tell you what that has meant to me. I'd better be going now.
No, wait, Sir Minister. For you.
Thank you.
Now, here, have a seat.
No, I'd better not. The Queen wouldn't like it if she knew I was still around.
Oh, never mind her. Sit down. This is between us.
Anyway, we're probably going to be preparing that test for tomorrow.
Actually, the test is all taken care of.
You couldn't tell an old guild brother.
Well, actually, I'm sorry. No.
I understand. Well, I'd better go.
No, wait, Simmons, don't. Have all your handkerchief.
What handkerchief?
The king loves that one.
Cardamon.
Now I bet you can't guess what the test is about.
Astronomy?
No! You'll never guess. Sensitivity.
Sensitivity? Did you hear? Cardamon the Great.
Cardamon the Greatest. Now let me tell you about the rest. Actually, I better not.
I'll go, but may I ask a quick favor? May I have this?
What do you want of that?
As a memento, because of my father.
Indeed.
Thank you.
A jester.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, yes.
That was a wonderful thing you did for that boy, Carter.
And all for his father's sake.
Say, I don't actually have to leave until daybreak. Why don't you and I go to the wine cellar, split a bottle, and talk about it. Talk about things.
Well, fine, but I've started something here I'd like to finish. You go down and I'll meet you there in 2 seconds.
I'll be waiting.
Excellent.
What's the matter, Chester?
Oh, nothing.
Say something funny!
Have you ever heard of my father, the Sliding Peter Jingle?
Is that funny?
I don't know.
I think the clown is losing his touch.
I am far from sentimental or romantic. And I'd like to think I'm strictly up to date. But at times the dead thing gets a bit too frantic. In these hectic days of 1428. So indulge me as I pause to raise my chalice to a quaint and charming dance he used to do. In the days when my dear mother played the palace, back in 1392, my dad was dead, and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he could dip and glide, and slip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always moving. I used to love to hear the people say, he's a little dancing. He barely touched the ground and never made a sound. But I noticed in all his rings that when he took his bow, the crowd in the crowd.
pocket from me. There you are. Ready for bed? You must be sure to get up fresh and early for your journey back to your kingdom, or wherever it is you're going. Bring me a bag. And the incantation. The wizard said it would be right here on the wrap.
Ah!
least old enough to be your...
Oh, well, we'll see.
Oh, Fred!
From now on, when I say hop, I want you to hop. Hop.